Hey everyone, how's it going? Today I'm going to be teaching you how to play Learn to Fly by the Foo Fighters. It's a really fun song, so I hope you guys stick with me to the end of the video. So we're going to start off with the rhythm guitar, and what we're going to do is a B power chord. So how you do that is you're going to take your first finger and put it on the 5th string and the 2nd fret, and then take your 3rd finger and put it a string and 2 frets below that on the 4th fret, 4th string. And then you're going to have the pinky right below that on the 3rd string. So that's your B power chord. And then below that, usually with power chords, you're not going to play the strings below them. But this time we want to play the bottom 2 strings open. So we have this open sound. So that's a B suspended 4 chord. So how we're going to play this chord is we're going to take that 3rd and 4th, so those are on the this is on the 5th string, 4th fret, and then the pinky is on the 4th string, 4th fret, and then you're going to have your first finger on the 3rd string of and the 2nd fret, and then once again, you're going to have those bottom 2 strings open. So this chord sounds really cool. It's another suspended chord, and those always have a little bit more flavor than, you know, your regular major or minor chords. So, and then that leads nicely into an E major chord. So I like to play that with these 3 fingers in this case, but most people like to play it with the first finger on the 3rd string 1st fret, and then the 2nd finger on the 5th string 2nd fret, and then the 3rd finger on the 2nd fret of the 4th string. So there's your E chord, and you're going to play all string. You're going to start with down, down, up, up, down, up. So that's down, down, up, up, down, up. If you prefer counting, that would be 1, 2, and 4, and. Down, down, up, up, down, up, down, up, down, up, up, down, up. We're going to do those 3 chords. So now we're ready for the lead part, and the lead part is going to be mainly just octave chords. And what an octave chord is it's kind of like a power chord without that middle note. So we're going to have the B, so we're going to have that 2nd fret 5th string with the 1st finger, and then we're actually going to mute the 4th string with our finger. So I just have my 1st finger, it's just draping over the strings. So when I hit that 4th string, it's being muted. Or you could also mute it with your 3rd finger, with the very tip of it. So like that. See how I'm just barely touching that. So then your 3rd finger is going to be on the 3rd string 4th fret, and that gives you your octave. So, and what an octave means it's just a higher version of this other note. So this is a B, and this is just a higher version of B, so that's an octave chord. Now what we're going to do is just simply slide it up 2 frets. Well, we're going to have that same down, down, up, down, up strumming pattern, and then slide it up 2 frets. Okay, and then on this up, we're actually going to bend the notes. And you can bend both of them, or you can just bend the 3rd, depending on what you think sounds the best. Sometimes I like to just do the 3rd finger when I'm bending. So you want to get that dissonance, and it doesn't sound good when it's isolated, but within the context of the song, it's going to sound pretty cool. So you're just bending that 3rd finger up and down. And then we've got up, down, and then slide back down to that other octave. So and like I said, you could also bend both of the fingers if that's what sounds good for you. Thank you. Now the second time we do that, instead of just staying on that last chord, we're gonna hit some extra notes. We're gonna hit the 5th fret on the top string, and then the 4th fret on the 6th string. So we're gonna go like this. Alright, so that's your intro and your chorus. And then I believe the second time through, it switches it up and it plays that those two notes the first time, but then it stays on this one the second time when it goes into that second verse. So let's go over the verse and how to play that. You're going to start off with this bar chord. You're going to bar from the 5th string down on the 2nd fret. And then on top of that, you're going to have the 3rd finger on the 4th fret of the 4th string, and then the pinky on the 3rd string 4th fret. So I like to have like a down up motion with my pick, and the first down is going to be on kind of the bottom two notes, the 5th and 6th strings. And then the first up is going to kind of be on the 3rd and 4th strings. And it doesn't have to be precise, but this is just kind of the idea you're going for. And then the next down could be either the bottom two strings or the 3rd and 4th. But then on the last up, you want to get those high notes in. So kind of like this. So. Okay, and then the second chord is going to follow the same picking pattern, but you're going to do that F minor suspended chord. So. So you're just keeping that picking pattern alive, but you're playing basically the same chords as you did in the chorus, except for you're barring and getting those high notes instead of keeping it open. Otherwise, it's the same chord progression. So let's play that together one time. And I want to point out why I do the E the way I do it here. It's basically because of where I'm coming from. So we start off with this chord, and then we switch over to the suspended, the F minor suspended, and or the F sharp minor suspended. And when I'm in this position, I already have my pinky right on the 4th string, so I like to have that just go down, and the 3rd finger is in place as well. So if I move from here to here, there's just more fingers that I have to move. Then if I go from here, I have these two fingers already in place and I just have to lay my 2nd finger down. So when I'm playing guitar, I always try to think of what's the most efficient way to get to where I'm going next. So rather than play that E like this and move all those fingers, all I have to do is drop my hand down and let my 2nd finger hit that 3rd string. In the chorus, it's a little bit different than the intro. In the chorus, the last time through, you're actually going to do a G and then an A. So that's when he says, "Make my way back home and I learn to fly." You're going to do "Make my way" is on G, and then on home you're going to do A. So the way we play the G chord is with the 2nd finger on the 6th string 3rd fret, and then the 1st finger on the 5th string 2nd fret. The 3rd finger goes on the 3rd fret of the 2nd string, and then the pinky goes on the 3rd fret of the 1st string. You're gonna play all of those at once. And then for A, there's a couple different ways we could do it. We could do it with the first three fingers, and they're all gonna be on the 2nd fret and the 4th, 3rd, and 2nd strings. So like this. we're not going to play that sixth string, just the bottom five. And the fifth and first strings are open. So we can do that with the first three fingers like this, or you can take your second, third, and fourth. That's easier for some people just because your pinky's smaller, so you might be able to fit it a little bit more easier onto that fret. But anyways, let's play that chorus one more time again. So we do the original chord progression twice, and then we go G into A. So. And then after that, all we have left is the bridge. So that part, you're gonna do basically, you're gonna start off with a B, that same one from the chorus. So I'm going down, 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 up, down. And then on the up, you're gonna transfer to the next chord. So, and so that's kind of different to go on the up rather than the down, but it goes a little bit earlier than you'd expect. And then you've got the G chord once again, so. Okay, and then we're gonna go to D. And when you're going to D, you can actually leave that third finger down right where it is, and then take your first finger and put it on the third string, second fret, and then your second finger can go on the first string, second fret, and you're only gonna play the bottom four strings. And then after that, we go to E. So far we have B, G, D. And notice how when I play this chord, instead of being careful with my pick, which is fine, what I like to do is take my thumb and actually cover the top two strings so that they're being muted and I can strum on them without them actually playing notes. But let's try that one more time. B, G, D, E, and then we're gonna go back to G, and then A. So let's do that whole thing one more time. B, G, D, E, G, and then it goes back into that chorus again, and then at the end all it's doing is playing that chord. So I hope you guys enjoyed that lesson. Let me know if you have any questions in the comments section and I'll try to get back to you. Otherwise, be sure to subscribe so you can see the rest of my videos. Alright guys, take care.